Welcome to our next podcast for the Management Board Unplugged. I'm Patricia Perrotta. I've entered BAT in 2018 as a global graduate in the legal department in Brazil. And now I'm here working in Globehouse in London as a legal counsel. I'm here today with Jerry Abelman, our legal and external affairs director and general counsel. Welcome, Jerry.
Thanks very much.
And I'm here also today with Kingsley Wheaton, our chief marketing officer. Hello.
Hi, Kingsley. It's great to be here.
BAT, as you know, has been investing in new categories. So, Kingsley, 20 years ago, when you joined BAT, would you imagine that BAT would be investing in these new categories and that you would be the one leading this transformation?
No, I wouldn't have imagined that. Things have changed, you know, enormously in that time. Technology and innovation in so many ways has infiltrated our lives. And it's that very technology and innovation that's allowed us to start developing many of these new category products. And we're really, really committed to this transformation journey.
How do you see changing the culture at BAT?
Well, I think the culture's always evolving, isn't it? You know, we have a fantastic culture at BAT. I think it's one of the things we should be most proud of. The culture's fantastic. I think it's born out of being a global business. It's born out of our many experiences together. But things are always evolving. So I think we're developing a culture now where we're bolder, where we're faster, we're more agile, we're more empowered. So I think we're becoming, if you like, a more progressive organization, embracing change and responding to the demands of our consumers.
Yeah, so of course, that's for that. We need to prepare our people for this change. So Jerry, how do you think are we doing that? How do you think are we preparing our people for this whole change, especially in legal and external affairs?
Great question. I think there are two ways. One is we have to bring in new people. And I think we have to bring in people from the right backgrounds, with the right mindset, ready for change, ready to be empowered, ready to take on more responsibility. But I also think for our existing people, we need to give them the opportunity, because I think they're chomping at the bit for change.
Yeah.
I think they want that empowerment that we're offering them. They want to be more creative. They want to explore the new categories business and what we can do. And within Lex, they're desperate to say, how can we help this business in any number of areas within the Lex function?
And what do you think are the main skills to develop to these new categories?
Well, I think it depends on what part of the business you're in. I think for everyone at BAT, it's an opened mind. I think it's having a mindset that's, you know, anything is possible. The technology is moving, as Kingsley said moments ago, is moving so quickly that we shouldn't shut our minds to what could be coming next. So every month, it seems, the technology is moving on. Our R&D people are creating new products, new ideas. And for the Lex department, that means whether you're in intellectual property, being prepared to meet the challenges, whether you're in the external side, understanding what governments are looking for, how we can engage with them in different ways, all of that has to take place.
What do you think people would find surprising at working in BAT?
The collegiality at the company is probably first class. I think we care about each other. I think we look after each other. We want to help each other. So I think that would be a surprise, because I think most people look at a large multinational company as rather impersonal. And I think we are anything but an impersonal company. I think we know each other. And as I said, we care about helping each other. We are open to new ideas. And we do have a very open mindset as we embrace change.
So Kingsley, a year ago, BAT announced a very innovative and technological partnership with McLaren. Can you share with us what were the expectations at the time and how are you going so far?
Yeah, well, we're 1 year into the McLaren partnership. It's been a fantastic year, the season of 2019. Everyone appreciates winning as well. So the fact that McLaren had a superb season was really good as well. We launched the partnership on the back of technology and innovation, really. And it really is a partnership. So I think the old days of sponsorship and branding cars, that's not really of now. Now it's about working that partnership, both from a technological point of view, from an innovative point of view, partnering with their R&D, but also activating our brands, both on car, yes, that still happens, but also at race, but away from circuit and through social media as well. So it's a way to accelerate our transformation, if you like, and also accelerate the building of our brands of this expanded portfolio in new categories.
Why did BAT choose Formula One and specifically McLaren to accelerate the development of the new categories?
Well, we didn't start with the idea just to do Formula One. We started a step back from that, which was a brief from me to ask what were the possibilities in terms of global partnerships that would help us accelerate our new category journey and help us build global brands. So we started with almost everything on the table. And then you start applying kind of filters, whether they be the things that we want or what's possible, the regulatory landscape, the worldwide footprint. And actually, when you go through all of that, I think, you know, it would be arguable that if you're thinking about technology and innovation, probably Formula One is the only real global answer at the moment that satisfied that brief.
And what do you think will be the greatest outcome of this partnership?
My dream would be we'll be able to say one day that our products have got McLaren inside. So I think, you know, although the R&D partnership is more slow burn, we are working on critical areas in terms of aerodynamics, battery technology, heat retention technology, which eventually I think will allow us to make better products for our consumers. McLaren has been, you know, absolutely fantastic for our business in 2019. But I'm interested to hear what you think, Patricia. How have you viewed the McLaren partnership at BAT?
Well, I think at first everybody was kind of surprised because what has BAT to do with Formula One? But when you really think about new categories, you see that it's something that really BAT has never been before.
But also at the end of the day, we're in the business of building powerful global brands. That's what we're about. And, you know, the brand equity improvement that results from our partnership with McLaren, that's what we're really looking for over the longer term.
Can I ask you, as one of the newest members of Legal and External Affairs in one of our most exciting markets, what do you think you can bring to BAT?
So I think that as I've just entered the company and I came from the markets, I've been a lawyer before and worked with another kind of industries. I think that I can bring lots of diverse thoughts and an open-minded mindset to the company so that I think this will contribute a lot to these new categories.
That's great. That's what we love to hear.
Jerry, how do you think we managed to balance such a complex regulatory landscape with the needs of the business regarding these new categories?
Well, first and foremost, it is a complex landscape, as you say, because we're into new categories and every country virtually in which we sell these has different regulations and different laws. But our utmost commitment, and Kingsley and I are absolutely aligned on this point, is we will follow the law, we will follow the regulation, both in the letter and the spirit. So there's no question about that. Now, if we feel that the regulations need to be changed because they're inappropriate to the category and adult consumers are not getting the right information, we will transparently engage with governments, putting our points across and hope that the process, open, transparent process, allows the regulations to be changed. But until they're changed, we're going to follow them.
Of course.
And it's a key, you know, it's a key thing for marketing and legal and external affairs for us to work together. I think sometimes when people hear the word regulation, you know, they get a bit frightened maybe, you know, it sounds a bit scary. You know, simply put, it's about rules and standards, and those rules and standards are put in place for really good reasons. They assure our consumer, they ensure that our consumer is safe, and brands represent these rules and standards as well. So it allows us to think internally about how we operate, how we run this business responsibly. And that's the most important thing. I mean, Jerry and I absolutely is one on this. We have to responsibly market our brands and our products worldwide. And that's why we have the international marketing principles, where it lays out very clearly, you know, if you were working in a business, what is and isn't appropriate. And I think that's absolutely right, because we have to be the kind of thought leader of the industry.
So, Jerry, what are your key priorities for 2020 in the Legal and External Affairs Department?
How long do you have? It's been a long meeting. I'll summarize them because they're big priorities and they're smaller ones. My global priorities, first and foremost, remains delivery with integrity. And this is the compliance program we kicked off in 2017 following the creation of a global compliance department at BAT. And we continue to run this program, stay with best practices, continue to drive a culture of integrity. So that remains a priority. And I think it's something everyone at the company embraces. As I said earlier, regardless of where you sit, what function, what office you're sitting in, I think everyone's embracing delivery with integrity. Another priority is the regulatory agenda.
Of course.
Okay? And absolutely And they all tie in with each other because we're going to deliver a regulatory agenda with integrity. But absolutely nailing the regulatory agenda is absolutely key for us. We want the right regulations. We want to follow those regulations to help our adult consumers and everyone at BAT.
Very good. And Kingsley, what are the main priorities for 2020 in the marketing department?
Well, marketing is a busy place at the moment. Yeah. There's a lot going on. The sort of next wave of marketing, 21st century marketing, technology enabled, dynamic, agile, collaborative. So within that, my personal priorities are pretty clear. First thing is deliver the results.
Of course.
There's a truth in life that you're nothing without results delivery. So we've got to ensure we deliver the results. The other things I'm going to be focusing in on is corporate communications, better narrative, better storytelling to the outside world of what BAT is and is about. And this is part of that, right?
For sure.
Talents of the future, making sure we have the right people in the right roles and that they're fully empowered. And they're able to make the right decisions, driving decision-making, you know, down through the organization, very, very important. Our culture, our ways of working and our behaviors. So, you know, you can't just wish for a culture. You actually have to work on it to make sure that we're becoming a faster company, a leaner company, a more agile company. And I'm also doing quite a lot of work with the United States. The US is a really big part of our business. Yeah. We acquired that a couple of years ago. We're still working to make sure we get the full benefits of integration, not the financial integration, but the cultural integration.
Of course.
And I spend a lot of my time working with the US guys on making their business better because it's such a big and important part of BAT.
So how do you see BAT in 10 years from now?
Well, I think we have a very clear view of the future. You know, we're on this transformation journey. It's about accelerating that transformation. It's about getting as quickly as we can to, say, 20% of our revenue in these new categories. We have to build a strong bridgehead with those. We have to continue to run the combustible business really well because that provides the investment, the fuel, if you like, that enables our new categories story. And in 10 years' time, I think we'll be a very transformed business. For me, the point is that we will no longer regard today's competitive set as our competition. I'm no longer interested in being the number one tobacco and nicotine business. I'm much more interested in us becoming, you know, the most successful, respected and valuable consumer products business. So if I was to summarize, we're going to go from a company that finds itself by the products that we sell to the consumer needs that we meet.
What about you, Jerry? How do you see BAT in 10 years from now?
I think it's going to be... a company that's known for having the best brand equity in consumer goods. I think it'll be known for having the best scientists. But I think our brands, I think our science, I think we will be known for having the best compliance as we continue with delivery with integrity. I think we'll be known for having the best talent and the best diversity in that talent across all areas of diversity. So I think we'll be seen as a very state-of-the-art company in all those areas, brands, science, our marketing, our compliance efforts, our patents. I think we'll have the best patent portfolio. I think we will be first class in all these areas.
Well, and I really hope to be here in 10 years from now.
If I can just pick up on it on a much longer-term horizon. You know, the interesting thing is BAT is nearly 120 years old.
Yeah.
You know, if you go back to when we were first listed on the stock exchange, there are only about three or four companies that exist in that form that they did over 100 years ago today, and we're one of them. Our leadership challenge is not to marshal the next 10 years. That's part of it. It's to make sure that in 100 years' time, BAT is still on that stock exchange.
So sustainability.
Sustainability, yeah. Absolutely. That we are a thriving, flourishing business in 100 years to come. And of course, we have to think about the next 5 years and 10 years and 20 years because we have to kind of roadmap that out. But, you know, really thinking about how this is a thriving, flourishing business in 100 years' time, that's what really, really excites me.
Okay, so Kingsley, what do you think are the main capabilities that we need to develop in our people to face all this change?
Well, we've obviously got a lot of really great capability from the business that we've had, you know, for a very long time. We now have to add to that with what I would call new wave or new generation capabilities. You know, something that not many people are aware of. We own 1,000 retail stores nearly across Europe. You know, so retailing is a skill. Of course, digital, really, really important. Yeah. I think it's too easy just to say digital. I think you've got to be specific. We need skills in e-commerce. We have really, really exciting ambitions in e-commerce. The application of big data, analytics capability to drive foresights. These are all capabilities that we have to bolt onto the business with a really, really strong core. And will help us build stronger and stronger brands worldwide and better respond to our consumer needs as we go forward.
So I think it must be very exciting for marketers to want to join BAT at this moment.
Well, you know, I joined BAT in 1996, and I was excited when I joined. And, you know, I'm excited every day. A boss I used to work for, that Jerry knows actually, used to say, I run through the shower every day. It was his way of saying, I'm so excited to go to work. And I still feel like that. I still feel like that all those years later. Now, you know, we all have our ups and downs, right? Some days are more difficult than others. So you've got to have to look at the trend line on these things. But it is a very, very exciting place to work. And I think as we look forward, it could only get more exciting as we face more of these challenges.
So thank you, Jerry, for coming today.
Thank you, Patricia. And let me say, you made the Legal and External Affairs Department very proud.
Wow, thank you. Thank you, Kingsley.
No, you're welcome, and well done. It was really good. I think I speak for Jerry and I, we both really enjoyed it.
Thank you very much. Today we've talked about our business ambition and journey and how all parts of our organization are evolving to support this, which make this an amazing moment to join BAT. I hope you have enjoyed this as much as I did. So thank you very much and stay tuned for the next podcast.